In this segment, we'll talk about Romberg integration. And we'll talk about the theory or the background behind how Romberg integration works. We're limiting our discussion to trapezoidal rule so far as what the Romberg integration is based on, because Romberg integration can be based on other rules as well, such as Simpson's one-third rule or Simpson's three-eighths rule. So we're going to limit our discussion on the Romberg integration based on trapezoidal rule. As we have seen, we already talked about the last segment about Richardson's extrapolation formula. In the Richardson extrapolation formula, we basically said that if we have n segments and somebody is using 2n segments for the trapezoidal rule, whatever numbers we get for the approximate value by using n segments and 2n segments, we can take those two values. So let's suppose if we call this I's of n, we call this I's of 2n. So this is what we get by using the multiple segment trapezoidal rule using n segments. And this is the multiple segment trapezoidal rule approximation which we get for an integral, which is of the form a to b f of x dx, of course. And we get the value to be I's of 2n. Then we can find a better value for the true value of this integral. It's still approximate, but through extrapolation, we can find this to be I's of 2n plus I's of 2n minus I's of n divided by 3. What this was based on the fact was that the true error in trapezoidal rule is approximately proportional to 1 by n squared. So as you keep on doubling the number of segments, for example, your true error gets quartered. So based on that, we're able to derive this particular formula here. And that's how we are able to get a better approximation of this particular integral here. Now, what Romberg says is that we can take these approximations which you're getting for the true value based on these two numbers, and we can continue to make better approximations by getting more values for, let's suppose if we get an approximation with n segments and 2n segments, then we can get 4n segments, then 8n segments, and so on and so forth. We can use that to get better approximations. What I mean by that is that, let's suppose somebody is using n segments, then they use 2n segments, then they use 4n segments, then they use 8n segments. We can always calculate the Richardson extrapolation formula based on these numbers which we are getting for the approximate values. So let's suppose this is I's of n, this is I's of 2n, this is I's of 4n, this is I's of 8n, the subscript standing for how many segments you are using for developing the approximation. You can take this value and get a better approximation right here. Then you can take this value and get a better approximation here. You can take this value and get a better approximation here. What Romberg is saying that let's take it a step further, or several steps further, is that we can take these two values and get a better approximation. So we take these two values, get a better approximation, take these two values, get a better approximation. So we're going to get a value here and a value here. Then we can take those two approximations and get a better value there. And that's how it will work. In fact, if we have more values from, let's suppose, 16n segments and 32n segments, this tree can keep on going. Now, what is that based on is that we got this particular, this first order extrapolation which we had by Richardson extrapolation formula. It was based on that the true error is approximately proportional to CH squared. So that's, or let me not write down CH squared because we're not talked about like that. That the true error is approximately proportional to 1 by n squared. So that's what we had obtained here. Now, what's going to happen is that the way we come up with better approximations, because we try to see that, hey, what is the true error approximately proportional to in this case? And then when we are trying to find some other values, or when we go down the tree here, what is the true error approximately proportional to? So that's what we need to look at and be able to figure out, that how can we get better approximations, because we cannot simply get this approximation and this approximation based on the same formula as we obtained these approximations, where we had simply I's of 2n plus I's of 2n. So here we had I's of 2n plus, let me just write it down here. So here we had ice of 2n plus ice of 2n minus ice of n divided by 3. That's what we had there. But it doesn't mean that this formula is going to be the similar kind of formula, or this formula here by which you're going to be calculating here will be by the same formula. So that's not true. So we'll see that how that works out. So what is based on is as follows, that if we know that the true error for Richardson extrapolation formula is proportional to 1 by n squared, that means the same thing as saying that it's approximately proportional to h squared, where h is the width of the segment. Because we know that n squared, 1 by n squared is simply a measure of how many, 1 by n is basically a measure of how many segments do I have, or what the segment width is. So we know that the true error then will be approximately proportional to h squared. It so happens that without proof I'm showing to you, that the true error in the trapezoidal rule is basically of this form. It is proportional to h squared, but if you look at the next terms which come into the true error formula here, again I'm showing it to you without proof. The proof is out of the scope of this particular class here. This is what it turns out to be. It turns out to be that the first order of the true error is proportional to h squared, just like we have shown it here. But the second term skips the cubic term, which is the h cubed term, and goes simply to h to the power 4, and the next one goes to h to the power 6, and so on and so forth. So this is what the true error of the multiple-segment trapezoidal rule will look like. Keep in mind that a1, a2, a3, they are not necessarily constants. They are based on the derivatives of the function which you are integrating, and it's based on where you are calculating those derivatives. So it's a little bit more complicated than I would like to talk about. So that's why I'm skipping it. So a1, a2, a3 are not necessarily constants. But what you have to basically concentrate on is that the true error is proportional to h squared. The next term will be proportional to h to the power 4. And the next term, the true error will be proportional to h to the power 6. So what so happens is that once you have, let's suppose, calculated the value with n and 2n segments. So you have calculated this value with n and 2n segments, which we call it I sub n and I sub 2n. Then you are using this particular formula based on that the true error is proportional to h squared. We said that the new value which we get is I sub 2n plus I sub 2n minus I sub n divided by 3. Now, if we are going to, let's suppose we calculate 4 sub n here, we get I sub 4n here, and I can calculate the value here to be I sub 4n plus I sub 4n minus I sub 2n divided by 3, a better approximation of the integral. Now, so what happens is that how do I refine this value? I don't use 3 as a denominator, but what I'm going to do is I'm going to say whatever this value is, let's suppose I call this to be J2n, and I call this to be, let me call this Jn, and let me call this J2n, these numbers, for the time being. So what will happen is that this number here, in order to get the better approximation, that will be based on J2n plus J2n minus Jn divided by 15, not 3. Now, where does this 15 come from? Is basically that, hey, that the error for these terms, that the true error in these terms is now proportional to h to the power 4. And that's where this 15 comes from. So the error in Jn and J2n is proportional to the h to the power 4. So that's why once you start developing the equations for it, you get this 15 here.